Hello guys, welcome to Sathya News. Now we are here with a new topic, binomial theorem. Today we are going to discuss how to elaborate a equation or binomial equation. And we are going to solve some problems also. X plus y whole power n. See, as there are x and y two terms, so we call this expression as binomial expression. If at all there are three terms or four terms, we call these terms as multinomial expressions. We'll discuss multinomial expressions later. Okay. Now, first of all, the expansion of x plus y whole power n. If at all we have x plus y whole square, what we do? As a plus b whole square is a square plus b square plus 2ab. But how we got this? There's a table called Pascal's table. And it looks like this. One, two, one. Now we are going to add 1 plus 2 is 3 and 2 plus 1 is 3, 1 and again so on. I'm writing up till 4. 1, 3 plus 1, 4, 6, 3 plus 1, 4, again 1 and so on. Like that up to n terms. This is a basic model of Pascal's table. Now, how we got this from here? So these are rows. This is first row, second row, third row, fourth, and so on. Now, if we want x plus y whole square. So see here, we have the term 2, which we have to take as the respective rows. Okay, 2 second row, 1, 2, 1. So here, 1, 2, 1 are the coefficients of the expansions. Now, after that, by ascending order, put the powers of the first variable. The highest is x square. As there is square present, x square into x power 1 into x power 0. And next. So, this is by descending order. And now, by ascending order. First of all, y power 0, y power 1 and y square. In this way, we can write the expansion. Add these three. See now, 1 into x square into y power 0. Y power 0 is 1. X square plus 2xy plus y square. So in this way, we have derived the formula x plus y whole square. Similarly, now let's try for x plus y whole cube. Now, first of all, write the coefficients. 1, 3, 3, 1. These are the coefficients. 1, 3, 3, 1. And the next is, according to the descending order. X cube, x square, x power 1, x power 0, and next y as ascending order, y power 0, y, y square, y cube. Put the plus symbol. 1 into x cube plus 3x square y plus 3xy square plus y cube. So, as we all know that x plus y whole cube expansion x cube plus 3y square x plus 3x square y plus y cube. If there are small powers like 3, 2 and maximum up till 4, if there is a term 10, how we should do that? For expanding these kind of big powers, there is a simple formula, which is, if there is x plus y whole power n, then the expansion for is nc naught x power n sorry, NCR x power. First I will expand it and write it in the sigma form. NC naught x power n minus 0, y power 0 plus NC1 x power n minus 1, y power 1 plus NC2 x power NC2 x power n minus 2, y power 2 plus NCn and so on here plus so on NCn x power n minus n is 0 and y power n. So this is the expansion of x plus y whole power n. And in a shortcut manner or in the sigma form, we can write sigma r is equal to 0 to n ncr x power n minus r y power r. This is the major expansion of the binomial equation. Please do remember this, x plus y whole power n is equals to sigma r equal to 0 to n ncr x power n minus r y power r. If we have y at the first and x at the second, we get here y power n minus r and x power r. Till here we have understood how to find the expansion of x plus y whole power n. If at all there is a if they ask the expansion of x minus y whole power n, how to find this? Same. First of all, draw the Pascal's table 1 to 1. And so on, okay. By taking example, let's derive the formula. Let's take x minus y whole square. We all know the formula that x square minus 2xy plus y square. But how we got this? Same as I said before, this is the second row. So the coefficients are 1, 2, 1. The coefficients are not going to change. And now multiply according to the descending order. X square, x power 1, x power 0. Now, there is a small condition for y. Here we should not take x minus y. Let us assume that this equation is in the form of x plus minus y whole square. So that we should take the total minus y term as a second variable. So that here we get minus y whole square minus y whole power n. Sorry, here minus y whole power 0 according to ascending order, right? Y is according to ascending order. Minus y whole square. Y power 0 is 1, x square. And here minus y whole power 1. As whole power odd number is there, we get minus, as minus 1 power odd number is minus 2x into y plus x power 0 into minus y whole square. Minus 1 whole square is 1, so y square. In this way, we got the expansion of x minus y whole square as x square minus 2xy plus y square. Similarly, that x minus y whole cube. Now, we got how to expand. Let's write the general formula. X minus y whole power n is equals to, nothing is there here, x plus, only assuming that minus y as a second variable. X plus minus y whole power n is equals to NC naught x power n y minus y power 0 plus NC1 x power n minus 1 minus y power n minus 1 plus NC2 x power n minus 2 minus y power n minus 2 plus so on NCn x power n minus n minus y power n. So this is our expansion. Now in the sigma form, sigma r tends to 0 to n minus 1 whole power r x power n minus r y power r. So this is the expansion of x minus y whole power n. You have to remember both the expansions, plus and minus, x plus y whole power n and x minus y whole power n. Okay. Now let's discuss a problem. Find the expansion of minus x plus 5 whole power 5. Okay, here is a binomial equation and we have to expand it. Simply use the formula. This is the first variable. Assume that this is the second variable. First of all, nc naught. N is 5 here. 5c naught x power n minus r and y power r plus 5c1 minus x power 5 minus 1 5 power 1 plus 5c2 into minus x whole power 3 as 5 minus 2 is 3 and 5 power 5 square plus 5c1 minus x whole power 4 5 power 1 and the last term is 5c0 minus x 5c5 here, sorry, 5c5 minus x power 0 5 power 5. And remember a thing, in an expansion of nth power, the total number of terms are n plus 1. I'm repeating again, in an expansion of nth power, the total number of terms are n plus 1. So here we have here phi. Phi has the n, but the number of terms are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I missed something. Right. 5c3 minus x whole square into 5 cube and 6. 5 plus 1, total 6 terms are there. And next I will explain how to expand this 5c0 or else something ncr. C is the combination and the expansion goes like this, n factorial by n minus r factorial into r factorial. This is the expansion of ncr. You get these combinations and combinations in the chapter called PNC, permutation and combination, and this is also helpful in probability chapter. Let's take an example. Let's take 5c2. 5c2 is 5 factorial by 5 minus 2 factorial into 2 factorial. 5 factorial by 3 factorial into 2 factorial. So first of all, what is mean by factorial? Factorial means, total n factorial is there, n into n minus 1 into n minus 2 into and so on up till 1. So now 5 factorial means 5 into 5 minus 1 is 4, 4 into 3 into 2 into 1, and 3 factorial is 3 into 2 into 1, 2 factorial is 2 into 1, 2 into 1, 2 into 1, and 3 gets cancelled, 2 2s, 5 2s are 10. So the value of 5c2 is 10. And similarly, by solving all this, we get the expansion of minus 6 plus 5 whole power 5. And a few points to remember, which may be helpful in solving of problems. X plus y whole power n plus x minus y whole power n is equals to 2 into nc naught x power n plus nc2 x power n minus 2 y square plus so on ncn x power 0 y power n, and which can also be written as sum of all odd terms, all odd terms, not odd powers. Okay, the next is x plus y whole power n minus x minus y whole power n is equals to 2 into nc naught nc 1 x power n minus 1 y power 1 plus nc 3 x power n minus 3 y power 3 plus so on nc n minus 1 y power n minus of n minus 1 x power n minus of n minus 1 y power n minus 1. This is 2 into sum of all even terms. I have given all these conditions in the formulas and description. You can check out there. That's it for today. Please like, share and subscribe to the channel. If there are any comments or suggestions, please drop them in the comment box. Thank you.